I'm Cholena Smart. I am a web developer and business owner with Mammoth Geospatial. And I'm speaking on sharing GIS data with GeoNode, which is essentially just like a power intro to GeoNode. A couple of years ago, we were engaged by UNDP Papua New Guinea to Papua New Guinea to build a couple of prototype, a couple of geo portals for them. So we built a prototype for Bougainville, and then we followed up with a prototype, production version for all of Papua New Guinea. I was hoping that my talk would be a bit of an intro for Joshua Turia, who is going to be here and speak in detail about it on the ground, but he couldn't make it, so that is unfortunate. and it was built in GeoNode version 3, and we're currently in the process of upgrading to GeoNode 4. So what is GeoNode? It's a content management system for geospatial data. It's valuable for organizations and communities that rely on geographic information for decision-making and engagement. For example, the objective of the PNG portal is to help policymakers and stakeholders in PNG make informed environmental policies and investments. So it's really easy for data users and managers to upload and edit and view, download their data. It's got tools for collaboration and sharing. You can create user groups and permissions, so you can create fairly granular permissions and then give access to either authenticated users or make different data sets open to public as well. It has collaboration and sharing tools, so kind of like a little internal social networking. And you can also create other content types such as maps and dashboards and geostories in there as well. So just a brief overview of its kind of architecture, really simplified version of this, but yeah, a PostGIS GeoServer Django backend, so a Python, and then the map store is the front end, which uses React and OpenLayers, and MapStore and GeoNode are built by a company called GeoSolutions, who are an Italian-based company, all open source. So, quick peek at the interface. So, on your that side is the data where you upload your data sets, and you can filter based on different like the metadata, different categories, search through your data and view that there. You can style your data sets directly in GeoNode, or you can also upload SLD files. You can also connect directly to remote services, and you can also connect to your own database. So if you have an established database, then you don't need to transfer all your data across into this system. The middle example is the maps page, which is a map called Marine Biodiversity Richness Map. So that's an example from the PNG geoportal, and it's using a bunch of different data sets that have been uploaded into the geoportal there. And the last category there, the geostories, you can basically add text blocks and images and data sets, videos, and create a scrollable geo story. It's a little bit clunky. There's smoother ones around that can make nicer looking stories. But the advantage of this is that all your data's already there, and you can kind of create it easily. It's an easy user experience. There's a plugin that's available. A QGIS GeoNode plugin, so it allows you to preview all your data directly in QGIS. You can pull your layers down as WFS or WMS, style them. You can push stuff directly back up with the styles from QGIS. We're fairly new to playing around with this plugin, so we found that there's a few things that are a little bit buggy, but that could be my implementation as much as it could be of the plugin. And I think that's it. Thanks.